Today we are going to learn about the pin configuration of Intel 8085. We all know that Intel 8085 is a microprocessor. It is a popular microprocessor. Its popularity was due to the availability of a large number of peripheral devices. There are 40 pins and this microprocessor operates on plus 5 volt supply. These are the different types of pins. The first one is VSS. VSS means it is used for ground reference. The next pin VCC is used for providing plus 5 volt supply. The next pins X1 and X2 are connected to an external crystal oscillator for generating clock signals. The entire operation of the microprocessor is on the basis of clock signals. So for generating the clock signals, the X1 and X2 pins are used. The next pin is IO/M bar. It is used for indicating whether the operation in this processor is for an input-output operation or for a memory operation. In this pin, if there is a high value, it indicates an input or output operation, and if this pin has a low value, it indicates a memory operation. The next pins S1 and S0 are status signals. By using these two signals, we could represent different operations, like if two pins have a 0 and 0 value, it will indicate a halt operation. That means the processor will become temporarily stopped. If it has a value of 0, 1, it is used for write operation. And if the value is 10, it indicates a read operation. And if the values are 11, it indicates a fetch operation. So S1 and S0 signals are used for indicating four different operations, like a halt, write, read and fetch. The next signal is for indicating the read operation. When the read operation is performed, there will be a low value in the pin. The next pin is WR bar. The WR bar means it is a low signal. That is, if we issue a low signal, the write operation will perform. The next pin is ALE. ALE means address latch enabled. This signal issues a high value during the first clock cycle. It is useful for storing the address in the address and data bus. The next pin is serial input data. It is for accepting inputs to the microprocessor. The next pin is serial output data. It is used for outputting. The next pin is ready. It is used by other peripheral devices for indicating they are ready for accepting a signal from prime microprocessor. The next pins are AD0 to AD7. There are 8 pins. They are both address and data. That is, they could carry both address and data, but only one value at a time. That is, at the first clock cycle, the value in the AD0 and AD7 bus will be address. And in the next clock cycles, they can be used for holding data. The next bus is address bus. These are A82, A15. That are 8 pins. The next one is clock out. If another device have to function in accordance with the clock signal of microprocessor, we could use this pin. The next pin is hold. This pin is used when another device has to use AD bus for data transfer. The next pin, HLDA, is hold acknowledgement, and it is used when there is a hold signal arrives to the microprocessor, and this indicates an acknowledge to that particular device. The next sections are different interrupts. Different types of interrupts are TRAP, RST 7.5, 6.5 and RST 5.5 and INTR. These interrupts are used for different purposes. When another device has to perform an input or output function, they have to interrupt the CPU, or CPU has to attend that device for that function or for that purpose. Different interrupts are provided. When an interrupt arrives, the microprocessor issues a sequence of instructions from a specific location specified by that interrupt. The TRAP has the highest priority. The other interrupts have a lower priority, and programmers can mask this restart interrupts, and we could not mask the TRAP interrupt. It is used in emergency conditions. The lower priority interrupt is next one, that is INTR. If an interrupt arrives, the microprocessor issues an acknowledge signal, and that signal is provided through the INTA bar line. These are the main pins used in Intel 8085.